The incident occurred at a time when the Red Cross Society is providing relief to the victims of this week's severe weather. Officials say the fire occurred around 5 a.m. on Friday. They believe the blaze was caused by vagrants who generally scale the fence to get into the property at nights. An estimate puts the loss at nearly $200,000. Ironically, one of the Mercedes-Benz ambulances used to respond to emergencies was itself overcome by the flames. Mattresses and other items used for humanitarian assistance were also consumed.
This morning about 4:45, I got a call that some section of the Red Cross was on fire. So when I came down, I recognized that firstly, there was fire from the ambulance going into one of our warehouses. We suspect that it might have been a zombie, using our colloquial language, who might have gone in there to sleep and possibly smoke, because we have no electricity, nothing of that sort, so to start any kind of fire. We always try to put all our combustible things away from the main building. So this place had a lot of blankets, water bottles, a few mattresses we are trying to get together to take to canneries and such. So we have suffered a great loss. It's a huge setback for the St. Lucia Red Cross. And for me, I am really, really fatigued with all these thieves and zombies that always seek to visit the Red Cross, cut the fence, jump over the fence, do all sorts of everything here.
Charting the way forward, Red Cross officials have already been in contact with overseas partners for help in recovering some of the items they were planning to use to help victims of Tuesday's disaster. They are also calling on members of the public who are in a position to assist persons in need as a result of this week's disaster.
My way forward would be, I continue seeing about the people of St. Lucia when I will just assign two or three persons to deal with this fire matter. But my business is to ensure that the 1,000 plus families that we have dealt with, which is about 5,000 plus people, that we continue to bring relief to them. Ours will be to go back to Viewfort, go back to Canneries, go back to Anstey, go back to Mac today, and to bring water to them. And we are very, very thankful to DGCL for the 1,000 cartons of water they have given us, as you see the 40-foot containers out there. And of course, Blue Waters did make some water available to us. Our friends and partners overseas, they are getting together to really support the Red Cross, and I'm asking them, please, because we really need to reach out to people. I cannot downplay this. I mean, some of us, we are okay, but those who are suffering are really, 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 really suffering. And something needs to be done, and done quickly.
Despite Friday's fire, the St. Lucia Red Cross Society has vowed to continue its relief efforts. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.